Sponsored in the Zecher of Nachum Shimon ben Rabbi Yitzchak Aryeh Kram on his Yortzeit in the Chof Gimel Iyar by his children and grandchildren, and by Ira Brown and family in memory of Ira's grandfather Eliezer ben Meir Zichron Livracha. This week is sponsored by my in-laws Benjamin and Barbara Selsky in loving memory of Pesi Elka Bas Nachman Moshe, my grandmother-in-law Alea Shalom, my precious grandmother-in-law Alea Shalom. I had the privilege of knowing, and by Avram and Miriam Deutsch for the Refuah Shleima of Perel Blima Basara, Moshe Zelig ben Rachel Minda, and Gadi ben Tzvia, B'toch Shar Chole Yisrael, B'toch Shar Chole Yisrael. I don't know, there was a box with the Sfarim. Does anyone know where that mysterious box goes?
There's like a few more right here.
There's a few left, so, yeah. This year, between the footnotes and everything, even if we learn like three lines on top, sometimes it's five pages of material in the Sefer, so there's not going to be photocopies. And this year, you got to get the Sefer. We got tons of them. So make sure that whoever takes pays. Also, one more important thing for those that are here.
I know. Right there on the windowsill for the payment information.
Oh, thank you. It's there?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Also, for the Chevra that are here, and even for the Chevra that don't live in the Zayit, but they live somewhere in Efrat, so it's Kedai. We have something very, very special that we started a few months ago with the Shalosh Shudduses that we've been doing. And I want to encourage everyone to come and be mishtatef with us. Shalosh Shudduses, Minchas at 6, and then afterwards we go upstairs and we fabrink Moshe Tzarich, I hope, Bezrat Hashem. And it's happening again this Shabbos, so I encourage everyone to come and partake in that. If you could open up, we're going to be hopefully finishing this wonderful mimer from Rav Biederman. Open up to page. Let me make sure I know where we are. Last week it was the Shmata Shabbos Torahs, right? Yes. Yeah, Shmata. So go to Daf Tet Zayin. Daf Tet Zayin. Starting off by quoting a Torah from the Nesiv HaShalom. Okay. Listen very closely to what's going on over here. This is a yesod. This is a real principle for understanding what life and definitely what Shabbos is all about. You know, it's Shabbos comes whether I like it or not. Shabbos comes whether I like it or not. It's very. One more thing. I want to dedicate this year also Leilui Nishmas. I just read something about your cousin. What was her name? What's her full name? Do you remember? Rivka Bas Daniel. Rivka Bas Daniel. Eilu Nishmas Rivka Bas Daniel. Ten Nishmas Tzvah B'Tzvah Chaim. So Shabbos could either... Shabbos comes whether I like it or not, right? Shabbos is Kviya V'Kaima. That's the Lashon of Chazal. That it's already... within the framework of the creation of the world, that was placed in the creation of the world. I'm having an amazing time right now doing Chazara for one of my children as a test on all of Sefer Bereishis, with a bunch of Rashis. And it's amazing how much, at least I, noticing things just by learning the Pshat of the Psukim again, with her, just going through the Pshat of the Psukim, especially just on every day of creation and noticing order of things, when things are exactly said, and how are they said that they come into the world, the way that Shabbos comes into the world. It's an amazing thing that we're going through. I love it. I hope she loves it as much as I do. I love it. She's like, Abba, tzchim, you know, we gotta get going. I'm like, but look at this Rashi, look at this, you know. But in any event, Shabbos is put into the world by when God created the world. That's how he created Shabbos, as we all know that famous Rashi. What was missing? What was missing up until Friday afternoon, Friday evening? What was missing was Menucha. That's what was missing in the world. Shabbos ba Menucha. Shabbos comes, Menucha comes. And in these Shiurim, all we've been, you know, harping on over and over and over again is making sure that that's not lost from the equation of how we go and experience Shabbos. And what type of Menucha? What type of rest are we speaking about? Let's see what he says over here. This is the Torah in Pashas B'Shalach about the manna. Mashed Darshu, it's the Midrash has a drasha on the pasuk. Vayvarach Elokim es Yom Hashvi. How did God bless the seventh day? Rabbi Yishmael Omer Berchu Baman Bekicho Baman. That's the whole thing of how God blessed the seventh day. He blessed it with manna, and he sanctified it with the manna. Berchu baman, he blessed it with man. Shekol yemos haShabbos haya yored omer, ve'ilu be'erev Shabbos shnei omerim. So how do we know that every day one portion came down, and then on Friday a double came, double portion came? So there's no chiddush here. The kitcha baman, and how did he sanctify? What's the inyan of sanctifying of kedusha? Shelo yarad bo kol ikar, that on Shabbos nothing came down. Vehu pele, Rav Biderman says. Understand the question, what he's saying here? This is the whole, as you say in Yiddish, the whole ganze Geschäft. Right? How do you say ganze Geschäft the whole ball of wax. That's the whole thing. This is the, you guys didn't hear that phraseology growing up?
Sure.
For sure, not ball of wax.
Not ball of wax.
Not ball of wax. Ganze Geschäft. Yeah. Yeah, one time. Oh, my God. One time.
Even I heard
it. I tell you, one time I heard it in a really nice. Someone was telling us, I guess he was a Rav Mechanech, about me to this Rav Mechanech for a while. Must have been, because then when I showed up at the Shabbos table, and then I don't know if I said the Torah or I sang a Nigun, so I overheard him saying to my friend, he's like, this is the whole ganze Geschäft you're talking about? This is the whole... Wow, was that a good one? That was a good... You would have loved that one. I was like, wow. Wow. Okay, thank you, Hashem. How often do you have the schus to really, really feel...
Humility?
Mamish, I don't even... It's unbelievable. Anyway, sorry.
All of us owe you.
I've got right. So Rav Biderman is saying, I don't understand. The world is around for so many thousands of years, right? And you want to tell us that the whole inyan of what God did in the world, Shabbos is all about, that he blessed us and sanctified us through something that only happened when? For 40 years in the desert. And when did it happen? Well, exactly. This is the whole thing. And that it didn't happen, right, even more, and that it didn't happen on Shabbos. This is the whole story of how God takes care of us, loves us, blesses us, and sanctifies us because of this thing of manna, which was so kivyachol finite on a time level. So this is so deep. Look at what he says here. The kavana amuka. התמינו חזל בדבריהם הקדושים אלו. There was a deep כוונה that חזל inserted in these holy words. כי בירחו וקידשו דומי הדמן. The blessing and sanctifying is likened to the manna. Wow. כמו שבאכילס המן היו יכולים לטעום כל הטעמים שבעולם, as we know. What did the manna taste like? Whatever you wanted. כמו כן בעניין טעמו של שבס, ביד האדם ליטום איזה טעם שיצא. This is so gewalt. I want to tell you, I'm like, when Yossi sits right across me, he drags things out of me that I usually wouldn't share, but I'm going to share it right now. One of my recent trips, actually I haven't been to the States, Chasdei Hashem, this whole year. But on one of the, a few years back, when I was, I had to hire some musicians for a show, so right before the show, I heard them talking amongst themselves about what's the latest and greatest in the scene of LA, which is the scene of LA, right? So they're talking about, this is like l'havdil elef alfei havdalos, that the latest drug on the market is called My Day Is, fill in the blank, that there's this pill that the chevra now are taking, where you take it in the morning, and you have the kavana of My Day Is, and then you take this pill, and it allows you to go, kilo, whatever you want your day to be like. Okay, funny, stupid, crazy, meshuggah, rachmanes. There's a lot of people I know that would love a pill like that. I mean, who are we kidding?
That's a
call. See? You know what it's called? It's called Shabbos. That's what he's saying over here. No, but that's exactly what he's saying over here. I think that's exactly what he's saying over here. כמו כן בעניין טעמו של שבס, ביד האדם לטעום איזה טעם שיצא. You taste whatever you want it to taste like. אלא שהחכם יבחר להגיש נויים קדושת שבס. The wise one will choose to taste the sweetness of the holiness of שבס. לסעדן באהבסו ואירסו יסברך שמוי. ואילו מי שאין בו דעס, נהנה מדברי הווי, הבל וריק. Now, we're going to a footnote, boys. We're going to a footnote. Chof Gimel, the page before in the bottom. It's a funny one. Mefursam Masholosh HaMagid Midubna, the Dubna Magid has a great parable. Maisa Be'ish Ani Ve'evyon Shebichas Mar Gora Lifnei Atzadik Al Rov Ani Ovedochko, a Nebuch, a poor man came to Atzadik and said, I have nothing over it, so the matzav is so bad at home. No money. Shalu atzadik, haim ish lecha I elu ma'ot babayit. Do you have any money at home? Ana, ish achein, yeah. Kol yamai hineni chosich pruta lipruta, kedei sheuchal lisparnes mehem bishnos ziknose. He has a savings fund. What kind of savings fund? A pruta lipruta. A penny to penny, a ruble to ruble. So that I have something later on. I have my own personal pension plan. But very little. Horalo atzadik. The tzaddik says to him, קח את כל הכסף שיש בישותך ולך עמו לשוק, והעסק הראשון שיציעו לך תמר לעשה. Take all your savings, go to the market, and the first business that you're offered, right, the first business opportunity that comes before you, go and take it. Do it. ויעזר לך השם יתברך שתצליח מאוד בזה, and השם should help you be successful in this. Wow, בלב מלא שמחה, מי הרעני על בייסו? This poor man gets so happy. He runs to his house. Kshumamim b'emuna tmima. It's perfect faith in the words of the tzaddik. Shedavar achad midivri hatzaddik liyashuv reikam. The tzaddik's words are gonna happen. Ve'alaf shekvar haisa hasha meucheres. It was already very late. He'ir et bnei tom mishnatam. He woke up his whole household. Ve'dorash mehem sheyutzil mimokom hamachbo. It's kol kaspi cheschon aseihem. He wakes everyone up and he says, listen, all those prutas I've been saving and everything, go and schlep them out, drag them out from wherever. Okay? Let's take it out. Why? Ki Rebbe tziva alav lashkiam be'esek tov. Because the Rebbe told me to invest it in a good business. That's how he understood the Rebbe's words. Akeres habayin tebita bo kemi shenitir fadato. The Rebbe tzim looks at him and says, now you've officially lost all your marbles. You're crazy. Ma atasach umayiraimach. Where were you? What kind of... What What pill did you just take? Basically, she was asking, right? My night is, right? Filled in the blank. Ve'od lehairani l'shemkach b'emtza alayla, and you even wake me up in the middle of the night for this? Lumasa ana ish bekoilas uvrokim, but he starts screaming, thunder and lightning. Haviu li amos betchifus, bring me the money fast. Vimashcha yadami lasinslo. She wouldn't let it happen. Achenit patcha menem tigra kasha. Till they started mamish getting into a fight. Now, tigra in modern Hebrew is usually. Blows. I don't want to say blows, but basically it was serious, okay? Batzayelu chazar la tzadik v'siper masha'arava ala balayin. He comes back to the tzadik, he says, can you imagine, you know what just happened to me tonight? Na'ana tzadik v'amar, achen, ki ha'esek harishon shebal yadcha yitzliach me'od.
What does that mean?
It means your first business, your first business transaction seems to have been successful. You successfully were able to have a fight with your wife. Do you understand? Listen. Hanimshal. What does this story mean? This is amazing. Amazing, tremendous amount of blessings come down every single Shabbos to every creation. The blessings are coming down all the time. The only shaila is, it's dependent on man, what am I using these blessings for? For what? For which business transaction am I focusing the energy on?
You need a kli to accept the bracha.
You need a ein kli machzik bracha ela shalom, Shabbat shalom. Ki im yivchar betovu v'chayim yizkel yisalos ma'ala ma'ala b'madrega satoira v'ayira. If I choose to say that the brachas that are coming down on Shabbos are here to take me to a place where it's all about going higher and higher for real. Ach im chalila yisasek b'dvarim shel mabekach u'binyanim tfeilim yire brocha b'masim elu. But if God forbid you use to take it to those other places, and that's what you're choosing to look to see where brach, that the bracha comes through. Halo l'shote u'lefeti yichashev. You're considered to be basically two different words for a fool. A fool. Im ya'abed hon rav beruchnius, if you lose so much of a fortune in ruchnius, tmurat dvarim gashmim al chofim ve'ovrim ke'erif ayin kecholam ya'uf, in exchange for materialistic things that come and go by the second. Lefichach kol maskil yit'ametz berucho la'asok b'torah b'tfilah b'vaday yeh Hashem yisbarach be'ezro. So it's a little bit of a hard mashal, it's a funny story, but it's a little bit of a hard mashal to bring down to us right now. I think it goes back to the beginning of Shir. Shabbos comes down whether we like it or not. That means the brachas come down whether we like it or not. There's a shefa that comes down whether we like it or not. And here, Matisyahu, I'm going to say even a little bit different. Even without a kli, brachas come down into the world. But what do I do? What do I do with the brachas that come down in the shefa of Shabbos? What am I doing with it afterwards? And the kavana that we have to have, and I was just hearing this all day on I forget when it was. When was the last? I remember. You know, one of the most pressuring things in the world is to be a sandak. Is anyone here ever a sandak? Maybe for anicles you were a sandak. Yeah. Why is it such a? It's a very, very intense thing. Very intense thing. You really. It's hachanas. It's the anavi Avram Avinu. It's a very. It's. Lom alma hadein, not from this world kind of thing. So my brother-in-law's brother, Tkoa, had a beautiful baby boy a week before Pesach, and Chol HaMoed was the bris. And he's mechabed me with sandakos, and it was Chol HaMoed, Pesach bris, Tkoa, amazing. It's beautiful, he named his son Amos Yair Shalom. It's amazing because Amos is the prophet that's buried, right? By it called Ya'ir Shalom. Well, I think that's the name, Ya'ir Shalom. Amos Ya'ir Shalom. Amos will illuminate peace in the world. But I was davening so much to Ribon Shleilam that I should trust whatever comes out when people are coming to get brachas. And for some reason, the same bracha, kimat, a variation, basically a nusach of the same bracha kept on coming down, which was, I said to everyone, obviously you should have such a shefa parnasa that to the extent that you obviously call me and say, how much does the shul need tonight to finish everything? Right? But then I said, you have such a shefa of bracha, of parnasa, and the kelim to know what to do with it. Because for some people, the shefa of bracha, of parnasa, is gehenom, It ends up being the end of their life. The end of their life, the end of their marriage, the end of their understanding of how to function in this world. So just to have the or without the kli, like Matisyahu was saying, can end up being very, very destructive. I think what he's saying over here is that a shefa of light is going to come down. That you don't have to worry about. You don't say, Erev Shabbos, please God, let there be Shabbos, let there be light, let there be Kedusha. Hashem's saying, bro, I got that covered in... That's how he created the world. That's not your zach. Like, you don't have to worry about that. That's for a Tuesday afternoon. That's for a Monday morning. It's for a Wednesday night. It's definitely for a Friday afternoon, right? But not on Shabbos. That's not the bracha of Shabbos. That's not what Shabbos is coming down for. On Shabbos, it's basically everything I do about Shabbos should be that I take what's happening here right now with me into the world and use it in a way that guides me to what's meaningful and what's eternal. That's the bracha. That's the key. That's what, and it's up to me. That's the man. It's up to me what it tastes like. It's up to me what it tastes like. It's up to me what I do with it. So, next page. Uma me'od yesh lashgiyotes. Ma me'od yesh lashgiyach ha'maisa b'yom ha'shabbos. How a person has to be really, like, every single thing you say, every single thing you do has to have an extra shmira on Shabbos. Sheri HaKadosh Baruch Hu ma'les adam le'echolo le'beis genazav kaniske la'el. De'en yeshiva sa'adam u'tnu'osa v'asakav hu levad v'veso ki yeshiva u'tnu'osa v'asakav v'hu difnei melech gadol. The way I conduct myself when I'm just in my home and no one sees me, you can't compare that to the way that I act when I'm in the presence of Malchus. Obviously, the goal is to have Malchus in your house, but it's just not the way we usually are. We're not the same. We're different when we're standing before a king. Ve'lo diburo v'archavos piv kirtzono v'hu im anche beisul krovav kediburo v'moshe v'melech. As the Rama points out in the beginning over here. He quotes it, the Rama or Chaim Aleph Aleph. It's just the way I conduct myself differently. Kol sheken, kshayasim ha'adam elibo, kshehu omed beveis ha'melech. That's true when you know you're going to come into interaction, you're going to see the king somewhere, you change. Here it's different. Here he's saying, all the more so when you understand, Hashem is saying, you're coming into the Beit HaMelech. בחדרים הפנימיים של המלך הגדול הקדוש ברוך הוא אשר מלוא כל הארץ כבודו והוא עומד עליו ורואה במעשה והשם invited you into the chamber. You know, there's a in the back of the man Shiloach. Where's Eli? Eli. Oh, both Elis. Okay, I'm talking about Eli Stone for a second, just because of you know, the Ishbitzer in the back of the man Shiloach in the Likutim on Tehillim. There's a vort, he says, I don't know if you ever saw it, it's a beautiful vort. How do we start by saying Shabbos? We say, L'chu neranen ala Hashem, nariya l'tzurishenu. So he says there a vort, he says, you know, all week long, everyone basks in the glory of the reality of living in a world that God created. And comes Erev Shabbos, and basically we say L'chu. We say, okay, chaverim, everyone else, this was nice. Now the private party begins. The king invites everyone into his inner chamber for the VIP party. That's what Shabbos is. Now, if I understood that to be what Shabbos is, that means now I'm inside. Now I'm inside. I'm different. I can't be the same. I'm invited into the private party. Next page. Noiraz Amar Harav HaKadosh Yesod HaAvoda. Yesod HaAvoda is one of the first Sfarim in the Chassidus of Slonim, the Yisod HaAvoda. Sha'arotze ladat, if you want to know kama hu mekushar v'davuk lebore kol olamim, yivdok, you want to know if you're really for real? Do you want to know if God is God in your life? How much to the extent God is really God in your life? It's not how long you can do his bodidus on a Monday morning. Yivdok v'yivchan es atma b'yom ha'Shabbos. Check and see where are you at on Shabbos. Ki kemidas dveikuso b'Shabbos, kach u'davuk b'kadosh baruch hu. To the extent that you feel it on Shabbos, that's really the indicator as to, you know, how much you really, really in tune with where you're at with the Ribono Shleinu. Shabbos. It's dafka on Shabbos, that's where it's at. Stomeret. You know, all week long I could have very high moments, and they, of course, they go somewhere. We don't know where they are, but on Shabbos, That is the indicator to tell me, where am I really holding? What's really real for me in this world? See where you're at on Shabbos when you're standing Bevez Genazav inside. That's when it really is. Where are you at on your davening? Dafka on Shabbos. Where are you at on your talking? Dafka on Shabbos. That's mamash, where it counts. That's where the change, that's where the indicator to know. What do you call it? That
thingy?
Barometer, thank you. That's the barometer to know where you're holding. And this is clearly what the pasuk is. So here's a beautiful kavana for everyone to have tonight. Beni uven b'nei Yisrael oishi le'olam oshi. It's a sign. Shabbos he os. It's a sign. Livchon veladat kama chozek hakesher beini uven bnei Yisrael. The gevalt. Os he. What's the os? What's the sign to indicate what? What's going on? Beini uven bnei Yisrael. Beini uven bnei Yisrael oisi la'ilam. What's really between us? It's a very, very long Torah, Reb Shlomo, in Parshas. It's either, I think it's Shoftim. Shoftim and Evan Shlomo. Shoftim or Re'eh, I don't remember right now. That the deepest thing that a person is makpid on when it comes down to being real or not is the in-between. That's what he calls it. The Torah of the in-between. What's between us? What do we have between? How close are we that there's an in-between? And it's all based on this. Beinu uven b'nei Yisrael. Yidin have remained Yidin because of what's between them and Shabbos. Like, what is that sign? Beini uven b'nei Yisrael, what's the in-between? You could say the same thing right now about what's going on in the world between Yidden and Eretz Yisrael. What's the in-between? What's the os between them and Eretz Yisrael? What's going on between them? It's what it used to be that it was enough. You know, there was only one time that I felt so much, like, pride to say the Tefillah L'Shalom HaMedina. Not Avinush Bashamayim, but the prayer for the what do you call it? Like, for the Commonwealth? No, what's that?
The welfare
of the state that I'm in. It never happened in America. It was one time in Canada about 10 years ago when Harper was still. I felt like the other one is Hanois and Chua Lamalachim, Apotze is David Avdo Mecher Evra. Like, what are Yidden gonna, what's their in-between between them and Eretz Yisrael this Shabbos if you're a Yid living in America? What's your in-between? What's the os between you and Ben Eretz Yisrael this Shabbos that you're davening for the strength of the leader of the country that you're living in? What's the in-between? By the way, Eli Michel is, I don't want to say ripping them, but he's calling out right, I saw an email that went out this morning. Calling out all the from Rabbanim, all the shul Rabbanim throughout Chutz Laretz, saying, what's your tefillah l'shalom ha-medinat America going to look like this Shabbos? If there's something oshi beincha ben Eretz Yisrael, something's got to give, something's got to change. So in our time, on a timeline right now, in life, right now the mifchan really is, What is your Bein Chal, Bein Eretz Yisrael for all of us, those that are here, those that aren't here, to know where you're holding? Like Shabbos is, the Bechina of Shabbos of Eretz Yisrael, hopefully this comes out a little bit clear. It's clear to me, I don't know how to give over the right words. The Bechina of Shabbos that shows up through Eretz Yisrael right now in the world is now. It's an os, meaning what's the sign? What's the indicator that has you showing that you're guarding the Bein Chal Bein Eretz HaKodesh? What's changed for you? Because you're being put to the test. We're all being put to the test to see, what am I holding on to? It's a very, very, it's like Ishbitz, in an Ishbitz language, it's the Birur of all Birurim. It's sifting through everything to make sure, to realize, it once upon a time was enough to make sure you go and march over there. What is it, Fifth Avenue? The Israeli Day Parade. That really was, to a certain extent, enough. No one can, there won't even be that this year. So Baruch Hashem, it's amazing that Hashem is removing these things that used to make people feel like, oh, see, Beinam Ben Eretz Yisrael. It's like, sorry, you don't have that os this year. You don't have that sign. I'm not going to give it to you. Great, push me for more. Shabbos, I always have. Shabbos, kviya v'kaima. Kviya v'kaima. So get back to here. Osi, le'avchin, livchon ladat, kama chazak ha'kesher bein yivin b'nei Yisrael. כאין זה כסף החיי אדם, זה צהל בספר זכרו תורס מיישה, וזה לשונו, לחיי אדם writes like this, יכול האדם להתבונן ולנסות, כי כאשר יכין את דעתו ותחיה יראת השם בליבו באמת, when you prepare your דעת, and you live יראת השם in your heart for real, ויהיו מעשיו רצויים, אף בוודאי לאחר שטבל בערב שבת, which is the next week we're going into מקווה, into the importance of the whole Torah of Mikvahs, Erev Shabbos. And after you tovel, he says, and you tovel b'chavana ritzui, the kabel kedusha Shabbos, to receive upon yourself the kedusha of Shabbos, meaning you did all the preparation. Yavin b'da'ato shenitvasef lo neshama yisera. You will actually not have to believe that a neshama yisera, this extra neshama, has entered into your midst. You will understand it. You will feel it. You will know it. You will be aware of it. It's one thing to believe, oh, an extra neshama comes into me. He says, with the proper hachana of what Shabbos is all about, based on all these Tabit Torah, no one's going to have to like convince you this is happening whether you realize it or not. You will understand in your da'at, you will feel that there's this whole extra thing called neshama yitera that we always speak about. What's that? That it's coming into you. Ki yavin b'da'ato shenitvasef lo neshama yitera. כי ירגיש בנפשו יראת הרממות שבאה לו. Because all week long, maybe my yira is on the level of, I really don't want to sin. I'm scared that if I sin, it's going to be bad for me. I'll blemish my neshama. But then the higher level of yira is called yiras haromemus, which means I'm in awe of the exaltedness of standing in the presence of God. It's much higher than being scared to not get patched. Do you know what that word means, Yosef? No. you didn't whatever. Atkan. So what's the click? What's the click that happens to me Erev Shabbos? He says, after the proper kavanas of understanding a little bit deeper what I'm entering into, especially after I toveled, which we'll speak about more next week, what happens to me is that suddenly I'm like, I'm not in awe. I'm not like, I don't go into Shabbos saying, oh my God, I learned Hilchos Bora this week. I'm totally toast because there's no way I'm not going to Mechal Shabbos this week because I learned a little bit of Hilchos Shabbos, the Malachas. I'm so scared now. Oh my God, I'm going to... He says, that's not what's going on. What happens to you is being... You have Yira, but being in awe, like, whoa, VIP lounge. You act different in there. You act different in there. Not Israelis. Israelis that get the VIP lounge, the sechut, hopping the things from the plates. Whatever. Some tikkun going on there. But he's saying, VIP, Shabbos, VIP lounge. Wow, Yira Saromim was different. I'm going into a different echal right now. Until the love and awe of God starts burning inside of you. Now, I love when they say this. We've seen this lashon, the following lashon, a few times when they've told us like that crazy things happened. He says, "Vize baduk menusa." This is what?
Tried and tested.
Tried and tested. Mikama anashim kama pamim bli shum safek. There's no doubt about what we just said over here. This has happened. People have come back from the battlefront and they've said, "This has happened. This has happened. This is not baba maisas. This has happened." But when I'm not in tune with the purity of my soul, meaning I go into Shabbos and I bank on the fact that, well, Shabbos is going to come whether I like it or not, and light's coming down whether I like it or not, I'm good. And Shabbos will be for you the 3-star countdown from the moment Shabbos comes in. Like we always say, a blind date, that from the moment you see her, you check your watch to see if enough time has passed to say, I was Yoyse Zayn. Reb Shlomo says, how do you test to see where Yidden are holding with Shabbos? Do they go and ever check for 3 stars? Unless you have to catch a flight, we're not, you know, whatever, there's always Dvarim Miuchadim, but If the way you grew up with Shabbos was that you kept on checking to see if three stars are out, this is not what's going on. All this stuff is not what's going on. So again, he quoted the Yisod HaAvodah, and Slonim is saying, if you really want to check where you're holding with God, Bichlal, how's your Os? Os, Beini Uven Bnei Yisrael, Os Hi La'olam. So tonight when we scream it, we have this newfound concept, maybe it's not new for you, for me it's newfound understanding, interpretation of how to approach this Yom HaKadosh V'Anora. I give us a bracha that everything we're learning right now, the way that it gets transferred on to our children, is only with love and excitement. And none of this stuff, it's the lo oved, it doesn't work. But this shine, that works. That works. Our kids should see us be so madly in love with the one above, with the proper state of Yira, and giving over to them the consciousness of, okay, kids, it's great, a lot of mitzvahs this week. It was really great. It was an amazing week. You guys learned so much Torah. Now, VIP. And this is for us. Hashem's, we got the ticket, we're going in. And for them to just understand, to internalize that, by all the stuff we're talking about, that's what goes into them, that when they're asked, you know, later on in life, we say this a lot in the women's shiurim regarding chinuch stuff, that if later on in life, if your child at a later stage in life was asked, play us the sound, if you could, play us a soundtrack of what your Shabbos table sounded like, if you could choose a song, right? So, we can get really funny and cute and start talking about all the 80s songs we grew up on, but the point is that you'd be proud of whatever song that they chose to illustrate what the soundtrack was like, that you'd be proud. Mm-hmm. If we have that, v'zachinu b'chol chayei olam, that's like olam haba, olamcha tireh b'chayecha, like, that's already olam haba in this world. If that could be given over, that'd be the highest thing in the world. Ashreinu, good Shabbos, good Shabbos, good Shabbos.